Hey friends, it's Judy back with another creative meditation video. Prepping for my upcoming Asia trip, I've been brainstorming how to set up my travel journal, and some friends recommended a flip-through video of my New York one. I must admit I got carried away, and the book turned out to be 4 times the size it was supposed to be. So it's a super long video, and I hope that it at least gives you some inspiration. I did 8.5 by 5.5 because it seemed like a good size that wasn't too overwhelming. It's held together by binder rings. I made the cover using just regular cardboard and wrapping it with scrapbook paper and laminating with a dollar store laminating sheet. My first page is the Imagine mosaic from Central Park, and I have the Cloisters photo as well as a New York City, I guess, map if you call it. I drew a picture of the Chrysler Building in pencil and attached a story that I thought was cute to that. Since it is in pencil, I put a wax piece of paper in between that sheet and the next one, which is a list of stuff that I wanted to do. So as you can see, I've checkmarked the places that I ended up going to, and I've written notes on the side. So for example, the Botanical Gardens, when I went in March, it was way too cold for it to be beautiful, so I decided to postpone the trip to New York Botanical Garden and the Queens Botanical Garden. I went to a bunch of small paper shops in New York City and kept seeing these Star Wars cartoon books. While I definitely cannot call myself a fan of the movies, I thought that these books written by Jeffrey Brown were pretty cute. This photo was taken inside of Central Park at Bethesda Terrace. Sorry about the shadows, I'm using natural light here. I included some Les Mis stuff in here because that was the one musical that I chose to see. It was my first musical ever and it was amazing. Here I have my login tag from Laughing Lotus. I went from studio to studio just checking out all the different teachers. This photo of the Flatiron Building is an awkward size because I actually made it to fit a previous binder, which I have outgrown. This is my playbill from Les Mis. It's inside of a vellum pocket I made because I didn't want to punch holes into the actual thing. I attached this binder clip to it so it wouldn't fly out every time I turned the page. The bottom is sealed with a vintage envelope flap. I have these small metallic images of St. Patrick's Cathedral and the New York Public Library. I did some foil transfers and thought that these negatives actually looked quite nice. Here's my Broadway ticket in a tissue paper pouch. And the New York Public Library again. You'll see a bunch of these line drawings throughout my journal, and they're actually from illustrator James Gulliver Hancock. If you haven't done so already, go check out his book, All the Buildings in New York That I've Drawn So Far. He's done some of Sydney and London. They're quite amazing. Here's a drawing that I did of the constellations inside Grand Central Station. That's the Taurus and Orion. I went to New York during the summertime, so there was a lot of free park yoga around. I wanted to touch base with as many of these as possible because I wanted to save money. On the back of the list, I have an image of Central Park from the Rockefeller Center. I'm quite an enthusiastic planner, and some of my roommates, having seen my lengthy itineraries, encouraged me to keep them. I rewrote them on scrapbook paper, and you'll see these pages come up in this video a couple of times. I found this black and white photo online, and on the opposite page I have my packing list. This is the Metro card I used, and some more images from Hancock. I used a mini clothespin to attach the Metro card and image, and to be honest, I'm not a fan of it. It keeps coming off. When photographing stuff, I often think of squares because I am an Instagram addict. Here I have Love and Hope in a small Ziploc bag. The next couple of pages are just my tickets to New York City. I made a Taylor Swift 1989 coloring page by downloading the image and then photoshopping it. I filled it in with Prisma colors, and during this trip I found that I kept going back to this one album. And even now, I'm quite obsessed with it. So on this planner page, I put welcome to New York because it was my first day there. And of course, it starts with yoga as soon as I land. I wrote down which trains to take and then, of course, dropping off my luggage and planning the rest of the day. At the bottom, I wrote down what I ate. I stayed at New York Moore Hostel, and on this page I pretty much wrote down pros and cons of the place. I stuck my luggage tag in this envelope that I made out of a map. I drew a map of Washington Square Park because that's where yoga was. I tested out different shades of green to see which one I'd like to color the park in with, and I liked it so much that I attached it to this page. This is the monument at Washington Square Park with the fake looking blue sky, and there's some notes about it. On the opposite page, some notes about the yoga there. I like to keep track of which instructors I had in case I want to take their classes again. So here I met Caprice from Sacred Sounds Yoga. I attached the booking confirmation for the hostel I was staying at. And here's the photo of Orion and Taurus that I showed earlier. Remember that pencil drawing? I wish I had better lighting in Grand Central because the picture is a little bit grainy. I wrote down all of the places that I went this day, including Journey to the Stars. I printed the schedule online and highlighted the days that I would be there. I visited the 9/11 memorial a couple of times when I was in New York, and I wrote down my feelings about it. Having documented that, I remembered that even though I went on super hot days, the surface where all the names were engraved was actually really cool to the touch. So Journey Through the Stars is run by astronomy geeks, which I love. They let you look through their telescopes at planets. I saw Saturn, which was about this big, and I took a look at the moon, which I drew here in pastel. On the adjacent page is a grainy shot from the Brooklyn Bridge Park. I walked down Park Avenue to see 7 aluminum art installations by Santiago Calatrava. I drew them here except for structure number 4. I'm not sure why, but I had a lot of trouble trying to sketch that one. So much so that I just gave up and printed it off and noted that it was so hard to draw. I included some pieces from MoMA by Yoko Ono. This one was associated with their wish tree, which I wish I saw. I didn't really even notice, but now that I turn the page, I see that we have the Imagine Mosaic, which was a memorial for John Lennon. On the back, a square photo of Bethesda Terrace. And another planner page. I write down things that I want to remember in the future. For example, on this page, I went to MoMA right at 4 o'clock. The line was way too long, so I went to Chelsea Market and then came back. That way, in the future when I want to go back, I know not to waste my time right at 4 o'clock, but just to go a little bit later. I have 2 tickets here, one from March and one from July. The tear-off portion allows entrance to MoMA PS1 in Queens, which I thought was pretty cool. Behind that is a card that says, "You Are Beautiful" by Yoko Ono. Those live inside this Andy Warhol Campbell Soup bucket that I made. I saw this Picasso piece inside of MoMA, and it is called Girl Before a Mirror. You can find coloring pages online, which I did, and used pencil crayons to fill it in. They had a bunch of Marilyn Monroe pop art pieces in a row, which I couldn't really get close to. I substituted her images using vintage Abe Lincoln stamps, chosen simply because I had multiple copies of it. Here's another can of Andy Warhol soup, and a map of MoMA. This scrapbook page was a little bit busier, so I chose to use it for a less busy day. Since I like the background images, I tried to write in the empty spaces. Here's my attempt at drawing the Brooklyn Bridge. Since this bridge is one of my favorite things about New York, I have a million pictures. This one is of the sunset, and I've got some journaling on the back of that page. I spent the next day in Queens. I intended to try this Lick art bus, but he drove off without me. I was not impressed. What I was impressed by was the Unisphere in Corona Park. No photo could capture its magnificence, but that didn't stop me from trying. I copied the Queen's Botanical Garden logo here using paint chips for the bold colors. On the back, I made a pocket out of a map of downtown Manhattan. Inside, a few images of the city with some journaling on the back. I wrote down, "In the city that never sleeps, I managed to find the busiest tourist attractions in their quietest times." If you take a look at these photos, there's like nobody in there. Here's a farmer's market map in a clear pocket. On the next page is a map of the High Line. When I first went back in March, I didn't understand why it landed on so many must-see lists. I got it once I went in July, because everything was in full bloom. I spent half a day there soaking up the sun. I popped into the Shala House for some yoga, then finished my day off at the Rockefeller Center. I purchased the Premiere Pass, which gave me one photo, and the viewfinder, which I found so useful. It helped me locate some beautiful landmarks that I probably wouldn't have found if I didn't have it. Here's another negative from my FOIL transfers of the New York Public Library. Let's see if tilting the page yields a better shot. I think it does, slightly. I went to the Metropolitan Museum of Art and the ticket allows for entrance for the cloisters. Here are my tickets, and behind it one of my favorite paintings. There was a series of paintings by Giovanni Paolo Panini that just have such crazy detail. I spent so much time just looking at it. He drew paintings inside of paintings. I was attracted to this Islamic print, which I found as part of the family guide at the museum. I made a pocket out of it and Velcroed the museum map inside. I saw Marilyn Monroe. And here's some stuff about my trip to the New York Botanical Gardens. The commute there was a little bit far, but it was so worth it. I highly recommend it. They had a garden there with some kale, and they were friggin' gigantic. I had to ask how it was done. I found this one online by an artist named Claire Lorden. I'm not sure I'm supposed to have it because it is copyright, but I loved it so much I had to print it out. On this side, I have some lavender in a pouch. They had this scent garden at the New York Botanical Gardens, which was so friggin' amazing. This lavender wasn't from there, it's actually from my home supply, but I wanted to keep it in there for the smell. I photographed Patience and Fortitude, the lions guarding the New York Public Library. I have an Osho quote on the back of one and a review of Lion's Den Yoga Studio on the other. I began my next day getting rained on during park yoga. I slipped so much on my manduka, so the teacher let me borrow a jade. Jade won this round. I attached information about the cloisters, museum, and garden with this New York map binder clip. I went here on the recommendation of one of my friends, and it was so great. It wasn't so much the medieval art that I was into, but all the buildings and the cloisters, they were just so incredible. And moving day, shifting from one hostel to the next. This is the entrance to the Manhattan Bridge, incredibly beautiful. Here are my notes on Chinatown, where I can get cheap fruit and ice cream and pizza and meals. I have some funny faces here because I ate at Columbus Park and there was some Chinese singing, which I can't say that I'm a fan of. Then I dedicated a bunch of pages to Modo Yoga. Not sure why I got so many pages in there, but it's definitely a studio I would go back to. I picked up some pretty business cards at the Artists and Fleas Market. If I wasn't on such a tight budget, I probably would have spent all my money here. Here's my experience with Governor's Island. I was taken on a tour and it was all in Mandarin, so I didn't understand a thing. I almost got away with being undetected, but one of the other tourists ended up speaking to me in Mandarin, and because I didn't respond, he knew that I didn't understand. Anyways, I picked up some trading cards and some maps from Governor's Island. I loved the drawings on the Trader Joe's bags, so that's what I made this pocket out of. Here's the postcard that I found for Artists and Fleas. And that was on my way to Smorgasburg, as recommended by one of my friends. I had iced coffee there, some lumpia, and a vegan burger. That evening, I went to the Guggenheim on their Pay What You Will day, and as you can see, I drew a blue trail of where I started to line up and where the museum is. It took me about 1 hour to get there. Here are some clipped images from the brochure, my ticket, and an attempt at drawing the building. Here's what it should have looked like. I kept all the information about the exhibits during that time. The cover page is a piece by Doris Salcedo. On this page, I made a note that Trader Joe's has cash back and they accepted my debit card, which was super awesome. I went to the Noguchi Museum on their community day, so it was free. Here I vented a little bit about the buses in Queens and I laughed at the streets here. I passed by 47th Road, 47th Avenue, 46th Road, 46th Avenue, and etc. Here's an envelope I made from the Trader Joe's bag. It's filled with wrappers and labels of food I ate. I randomly have a spoon in here too, from the Trader Joe's grocery bag. And I made some notes on them, for example, ones that acknowledge my affinity for mac and cheese. This was my key card for High New York Hostel and the slip to open up their storage lockers. My last day was spent in Central Park because it was most special to me. I took these shots of Alice in Wonderland and Hans Christian Andersen. I'm very pleased with the way they turned out. I've got my return tickets here and I guess a copy of the home screen of my phone. Some of these are just business cards. Others are apps that I relied heavily on, and some are apps that I had to remove in order to create space for photos. These are the ones with the X's. As mentioned before, I was on a strict budget and noted all spending. Then I have two separate lists, one for purchases and one for food, obviously because it separates the wants from the needs. I made this small envelope to hold receipts. It's made out of scrapbook paper and just a Statue of Liberty that I found in one of the brochures. The last section is labeled Until Next Time. Worth mentioning is Prospect Park and Brooklyn Botanical Garden, which I planned for this trip. I even wrote down which metro routes to take and which date was free, but I simply didn't have enough time. Most of these just act as ideas. I mean, I'm good either way. If I go, that's awesome. If I don't go, that's okay too. One thing that I definitely want to go to next time is the Balloon Saloon. I walked past it on my way to yoga, but obviously I didn't want to be late, so I just walked past it. This is me holding a bunch of balloons and the house from up. On the back I have a map of how to get there. And at the end I just have a whole bunch of maps that'll help me navigate the next time I'm there. I put a little sticker on that one that said I'd map that. It was something that I saw at the subway. This was from a coloring page. It's the Empire State Building, and then I have a flying man on the right hand side. As you can probably guess, it's from Trader Joe's. I clearly did a lot of my shopping there and am obsessed with the bag. That's all I've got, finishing off with a deserted Brooklyn Bridge and one of the rising sun. Thanks for keeping with me all the way to the end. See you soon!